Hey guys, welcome to another video on my channel. So today what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be kind of reviewing the Spiral Heavy Weapons which we are currently testing on the test server this weekend. So there are three variations of it. If you want to read up more about it, make sure to pause the video because I'm kind of scrolling through each one just to kind of get the descriptive window so that you guys, you know, at least have something to go with. I'm now going to be switching over to Spiral Heavy Weapon number 1. I have stats, you know, on the screen right now, so if you want, you can pause that and read up on it. I'm now going to be taking a 3D view or a look of this weapon. This is actually not what the weapon will look like. It's a prototype. I put it on the Butch because I found that I could see the weapon better on the Butch. And this is just basically a teaser look at it. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to load up a hanger. And I've kind of done it to where I would fire only one of the weapon, two of the weapon on the Carnage, three on the Fury, and then four on the Butch. Okay, so this is going to be game number 1 on Canyon map using these weapons on the builds which I just kind of showed. Once again, I kind of split it up so you could kind of see how much damage it did. Also, it's better to see the, I guess, mechanics and behavior of the weapon when I've spread it out like that, instead of running, like, say, three on, like, a Fury and having five of those, or, you know, five Butchers and just running four. I kind of did, like, one, two, just so that you can kind of see the damage variation as well. But anyways, I'm not going to be talking too much. I just wanted to kind of explain, you know, my thinking behind choosing the hanger, going through the stats and all of that good stuff. But yeah, just enjoy the game, and I'll check back with you after this game where we will review Spiral Heavy Weapon number 2. So now that we've taken a look at Spiral Heavy Weapon number 1, let's take a look at Spiral Heavy Weapon number 2. If you want, you can pause this video. I do have some of these stats on the screen right now, in case you are interested. And then from here, we're going to be transitioning into a 3D look of this weapon. So again, I put it on the butch because it was easier to see. This is sort of a first glimpse, sort of a sneak peek, if you will, of what the weapon could look like. Again, we don't really know if they're going to be going with this weapon, but that is kind of what they have in mind for the design of it. I set up my hangar very similar to the other one, where I kind of did variations where I could fire one weapon, two weapon, three on a Fury, four on a Butch. For the second Fury though, I did add an Ansel because I noticed a lot of players were running Ansels, and again the Ansel did get a buff, so why not? I decided to include two games of the Spiral Heavy Weapon number 2, mostly because this game ended up being rather short. My team decided to capture all the beacons, and yeah, you know how it goes. When you're on a test server, everyone captures the beacons and the game ends and you're like, well, I didn't even get to test the weapon. And the other reason also why is because there was a funny moment which happened in this game, which you'll see later on. So that's why I decided to include this clip. There will be another game after this using this weapon as well. But in terms of, you know, which weapon or which variation I like the most, I think I like the second variation the most, which is the one that I'm running right now, and you'll be able to see the reason why. The other two I found kind of fired too much like, I think, the Spiral and Hydra. This one sort of reminds me a bit of the Swarm weapon a while back, so that's why I kind of preferred that. But anyways, I'm not going to be talking too much. I just wanted to kind of give you some insight or the reason why I decided to include two clips over one, and why I prefer this weapon or this variation over the others. So once again, after the two games, or at least the second game, I will check back with you and we will review Spiral Heavy Weapon number 3. Okay, so this is the final variation of the spiral heavy weapon. So this is spiral heavy weapon number 3. If you want, you can pause the video. I do have the stats on the screen right now. And then after this, we're going to be transitioning into a 3D look of the weapon again. I've put it on the butch just so that you have a better glimpse or an idea of what this weapon could look like if it were to be developed. Again, it's more of a sneak peek or a teaser of what the weapon could look like. And then in terms of lineup, I did pretty much the same thing as what I did with the other games. Very similar lineup, except it's now heavy weapon number 3. Okay, so this is going to be some of my gameplay using the spiral heavy weapon number 3. I think straight off the bat, you're going to notice that the behavior mechanics is very similar to variation number 1. However, this third variation does do more damage, so that's something to keep in mind. So what do I think of all these variations, or this weapon just in general? I'm not really a fan of spirals. Being able to fire from 600 meters away and have it be heat seeking on top of that, and even worse, if it does a lot of damage, I think it's gonna kill the game in terms of, you know, all these campers. I think it will encourage camping, so that's one thing that I really don't like about spiral weapons. However, if I had to test, or at least choose, out of the three variations, which one I like the most in terms of mechanics and behavior, definitely the second one. So that's kind of my choice. But again, I'm not really in favor of this. There's something that I did notice, though, a lot of players were running Ansels as well. And I think it was just to protect themselves from all these incoming spirals. So that's one thing that I did notice. But yeah, that's pretty much going to be my review, I think, of these three heavy weapon spirals. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do subscribe. I also have links to all my social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, as well as my Twitch channel. I have all of that in the video description, as well as those who are interested in, you know, my recording software and pretty much what I play the game on. I do have a link for that as well. And I guess until the next video, I will catch you guys later.